Good morning, students. I hope you might have gone through your chapter one of English grammar. And let us today begin the second chapter. That the name of the chapter is phrases. So we shall study today what is phrases. But I would like to ask all of you whether you have finished your homework, what I had given to you. But I had done all the exercise. Have you gone through the exercise? Have you write down? Have you written down in your own notebook the definition of definitions and the send how many kinds of sentences? I hope I think I had given you all one exercise also to write in your notebook. If you have not finished the homework, please do it. Please write down the definition kind of sentences and their one example. And the exercise which I had told you already in of chapter one, the sentence. So please write down in your notebook. Okay. Now, let us study today what is phrases. Okay. What is phrases? Now, here one example is given here. Examine the group of words given below. In the east. Now let us read the next, then only you will understand. This group of words makes sense but not complete sense. Now this group of words making sense but not complete sense. Such a group of words which makes sense but not complete sense is called phrase. So please write down this definition in your notebook. Okay, this is your homework. Now, a phrase does not contain a phrase. Now, let us see. A phrase does not contain a predicate either expressed or understood. In the following sentences, the group of words. Now, here we shall see. Let us read the sentences. They sat on a wall. He turned to the left. Now, thus phrases become meaningful when they are part of a sentence. Now, suppose these only phrases are given to you. What do you understand by this? There is no, doesn't make any sense. Okay, group of words make sense, but then there is no complete sense. That's why I'm calling it that doesn't make any sense means there is sense, but then there is no complete sense. He turned to the left, to the left. To the left means. Now you have to join these phrases into the sentence, then it will give you the correct meaning. So please write down this one also in your notebook. These phrases become meaningful. These phrases will become only meaningful when they are added with the, they become the part of the sentence. Now how many kinds of phrases are there? Now there are three kinds of phrases. First one adjective, second one adverb, and third one is noun. So today, now we shall begin adjective phrases. Now, adjective phrases, examine letters. Number one, it is a golden ring. Okay. Yeah, a golden ring. It is a ring made of gold. Okay. She is a blue-eyed girl. She was a girl with blue eyes. Now, let us go through the examples. We will understand better in clear way. In each of the above pairs of sentences, we have first a single word describing the person, okay, or thing denoted by the noun, and then group of words describing the person or thing denoted by the same noun. For example, now let us see. The group of words of gold tells us what sort of ring is. Now group of gold will tell you ki ring kis cheez ki bani of gold. It qualifies the noun ring just as an adjective does. Okay, it therefore does the work of an adjective is called an adjective phrase. This definition you will write down one and then you write this example also. Okay, so an adjective phrase is a group of words that does the work. Ek adjective phrase group shabdo ka samuh jo adjective ke does the work of an adjective jo adjective ka kaam karta. Okay, now this you will read again. An adjective phrase is a group of words that does the work of an adjective. Yes, our adjective phrases, group of words, ek adjective ka kaam karte. Okay, this also you will write and this also and this one example in your notebook. Now, here one exercise, one list is small exercise not to do, but you have to learn. Okay, adjectives are here and these are the adjective phrases. A blank page, a page with no writing. Okay, so you can go through this whole exercise, this whole read and learn. Okay. Then it is continued here, that is not over. So till here you have to learn. Okay, this is your homework, learn. After this we shall see adverb phrases. The work of an adverb is often done by a group of words. Okay, he ran quickly, he ran with a great speed. Now you can go through these sentences, but I will explain to you. Now let us go through an example. Each one of the following pairs of sentence, we have first a single word, okay, an adverb modifying a verb. Then a group of words, we have modifying the verb in the same way, okay. For example, the group of words with great speed tells us how he ran, okay. This with great speed is explaining to you how did he run. He ran with a great speed. It modifies the verb ran as the verb adverb quickly does. It therefore does the work of adverb. And it is called adverb phrase. This you have to write in your notebook and this example too. An adverb phrase is a group of words that does the work of an adverb. Now here, as adjective was given to you to learn, in the same way this adverb is given, adverb phrase and adverb. These are the adverbs and these are the adverb phrases. Beautifully, number one, in a beautiful style. So you can go through that. Now examine the following sentences and notice the work done by the phrases. Now you have to examine and see the work done by the phrase in each. A house on an island was washed away. They live on an island. In one sentence, on phrase on an island tells us which house was washed away. Okay, a phrase on island tells us which house was washed away. That is, it qualifies the noun house and it is called adjective phrase. Number two, a phrase on island tells us where they live. Where they live. It modifies the verb live, adverb phrase. Okay. Now, you have to go through these examples and read and understand yourself. Then only you will understand, otherwise wrong. You have to work your own. Now, noun phrase. The man wants something. He hopes to win the prize. Okay. In one sentence, the word something is a noun and it is the object of a verb wants. Okay. Something is a noun and it is the object of the verb wants. Now, second group, the group of words to win the first prize is the object of the verb hopes. Okay. This is a verb and this is the object. Okay. Now, hence, this group of words does the work of a noun. The group of words to win the first prize is therefore a noun phrase. A noun phrase is group of words that does the work of a noun. Please write down this also in your copy. And this example also you will write. Further example of noun phrases you can go through. I hate to do such a thing. We enjoy reading novels. Did you enjoy reading this magazine? Do you win? Please underline like this when you write in your copy. Now, once again, you have began your second chapter, phrases. You will write this. What is phrase? Then put one example and this also you will write. Then you will understand better. This also you will be writing. How many kinds of phrases are there? 1, 2, 3. Then first you will write this, then you write this, then you have to write one example. this you will write. One example you will write. Then from here, first you will write this, then you write this. This you will be writing in your copy, okay? This is your learn and write in the notebook. Then you have to learn this. This no need of writing, but you will learn. This you will write. And these examples. This you will write. This you will write. This examples. So dear students, I hope you might have understood, and I know you will learn. So please spend your time in studying. Don't waste your time at home. Go through this video, understand all three kinds of phrases, and write down all the definitions with the examples whatever I have given you. The one exercise also I have given. So please do the work on time. So in second video I shall give you all the exercises for your understanding and learning. So this chapter you go through and learn yourself. Thank you.